Recently, photographer Joshua Brentwood, who specializes in photographing not only the royal family, but also various festivals, celebrations, and other events, showcased a certain letter from the palace itself. Let's break down this important news. The letter was sent to him marked as private and confidential. The photographer was summoned to the palace, and this was immediately noticed by the media. They began to speculate that an important announcement from the royal family might be forthcoming. It should be noted that some news outlets have already reported on the upcoming palace announcement, citing the photographer and Jose Morna. They wrote that a professional photographer was summoned to the palace, suggesting that something very interesting and important might be in the works. It is known that the photographer was hired on a private, confidential basis. This request was made by the British royal household on Thursday, June 27. However, there have been no statements from the palace or its representatives. What is most curious is how quickly this information spread across the internet. Why is this happening? Are we being subtly prepared for something? Let's try to understand this matter. The photographer himself was very surprised by the sudden growth in his followers after all. He posted the photo himself. Now he's wondering if he did it on purpose or if someone advised him to leak the news online. After the photo was published, everyone was expecting something interesting. But today, realizing that he shouldn't have shown the letter, he began offering explanations. He had wanted to become an official royal photographer, but he was rejected. Then he saw the news in the press about the upcoming palace announcement, with a reference to his social media account, and he explained, "Oh God, this article is completely insincere and entirely fabricated. This online publication made up a story about my letter from Buckingham Palace. This morning, I clarified that the content of the letter has nothing to do with any announcement from the palace." So, it's unclear why royal correspondents, particularly Jose Morna, who has always warned about palace announcements, decided that there would be news about the royal family. By the way, it was Jose who first warned that there would soon be an announcement from Catherine and possibly news about Charles's recovery. If there are no upcoming announcements from the palace, it's curious why the rejection came with such a note. Do you think someone is deliberately creating distractions by giving us different information? Or is someone or something trying to divert our focus from important news to secondary issues? What do you think about all this? Write to me with your opinion. Well, let's move on. Fortunately, there's more to discuss. Pat McAfee criticized ESPN for including Prince Harry on the shortlist of nominees for the Pat Tillman Award for Service. He also expressed regret that Americans were not considered in the selection process. To clarify, ESPN announced that Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex, would receive the Pat Tillman Award in recognition of his service in the British Armed Forces and his work with the Invictus Games. Discussing the prospect of the Duke of Sussex receiving this prestigious award, which is given to someone with a strong connection to sports, the ESPN analyst was not afraid to speak out before the event committee.